But coming to the question regarding the speed and the delivery. Well, see, again, I think to start with, as part of the organization, as part of consulting, and you take up all these projects as well, you always have a tremendous pressure to deliver something within probably 3 months or 6 months, and maybe the expected, or when you start doing a mass, it comes out to be, let's say, your own project. But I think we are living in this world in which we are talking about digital era, we are talking about digital transformation, and all this paradox. I think one thing that at least strategy consultants like us have learned from IT was something like a agile approach, which has been being adopted by a lot of us in the recent past, is that fail fast. And that actually helps you figure out, okay, what should be the right path going forward in this complex environment. I think I could quote a very good example of a movie, Apollo 13. I'm not sure how many of you have seen that. I think that was a very classic case where you where something has gone wrong in space. And the team down here, the leader, has just given them a few things that, okay, guys, this is what you have, make it work. That agile approach with the limited resources at hand, that's a very good example, as we are seeing in our in industries as well. That we are in a complex situation, competitor has come out, instructor has come out, taken a huge amount of share from us. How can we best resolve the situation? Or we're talking about this new digital thing, product to services, customer to collaborator. Can we now resolve this kind of a paradox by adopting, let's say, some small pilots in a very agile approach, and let that pilot answer or find out a way on its own, or recommend a way on its own? That's one way to handle it. The second way, I think what worked for us was always a priority. I mean, let's be more pragmatic, that you cannot boil the ocean overnight. Not boil ocean at all. So let's be very pragmatic at what are the key priorities that we have for our stakeholders, for our shared share value holders, or whoever the stakeholders are. Let's have that priority set. That will further help you in managing this kind of paradox. We believe that you cannot just run away with a quality with a shoddy job. So a quality has to be there. You cannot just go after as a strong brand name. That's why people call you. If they have to do some bit of a patchy job, they could have gone anybody there, no dirt on consulting firms. But if a top-notch consulting firm has been called, it has to be delivered in a high-quality manner. Now, at that time, if there are certain cases, then we really have to come up, sit together across the table and get things prioritized, and then chalk out the right roadmap and then deliver that. Frankly, gone are the days when consulting, like I've been there for since last decade. Last decade and this decade, I see a massive change. In fact, my mentors used to tell us that that the consulting deliverable of last decade is actually now proposed. So much rigor is expected from the client, and it's not that because for simple reason, clients are getting smarter day by day. You cannot take clients for granted today. So that kind of a rigor that is expected cannot come if you compromise on a quality. So speed is, yes, definitely there, so you have to prioritize it, bring in some of the best practices, or move to an agile approach, but you cannot have a, frankly, quality is not a choice, actually. You have to deliver that for the right quality. So that's balancing act and